Hi folks, I'm Ian Baker, the product specialist with Camping World, and today we're going to go over the 2018 Mallard 312. This is a great bunk model. It's awesome for young families. As you can see, it's nice and open. And the thing I like about this floor plan is traditionally when you have the rear corner bunks, you're somewhere in like a 26 to 27. This one's a little bit longer where you're starting to get into where they normally have a bunkhouse. But because they went with rear corner bunks, it gives you some awesome amenities in here. Let's start off on the kitchen and then we'll make our way through. So you see you have good prep space here. You have some space right over here to the side. And more importantly, they gave you a recessed cooktop with a glass cover. That way you can use this as prep space as well. Nice and easy to get to those burners. Just fold this up and back. This kind of acts as a backsplash here. And then you have the three burners there, the front one being high output. And directly underneath is the oven. If we move over a little bit, we have some storage right under here. You have your sink top covers here. These are nice. You'll see you have one for each sink basin, obviously. And they are cutting board quality. So if you want to take them off, you can flip them over like this. Use the bottom as cutting boards. When you're done, you can put them right back on nice and easily. And obviously, when they're on there, you can utilize that as prep space as well. But that storage right underneath is perfect, again, for a trash can. Take a look at the faucet. You have a super high-rise faucet here. It's a pull-out faucet too, folks. That makes it nice and easy to wash and rinse your dishes. And then if we take a look right over here, you see you have a cubby hole there. Then you have two large full extension ball bearing drawers right here. Open that one up for you so that we have a place for your silverware and some of your other utensils as well, like your spatulas, spoons, and some of the other larger things like knives. You also see you have a window right here. That way it lets natural light in during the day. LED light right up top for light at night. And then as you would expect, you have pantry storage up top there. You don't have a stile in the center, so it is a little bit more open space in case you do have bigger items that you want to fit up there. You also have the microwave as well as the hood with a light and a fan. And then rounding out the kitchen right over here is the Dometic fridge freezer combo. You have a cutout there for some taller items. This unit does run off both propane and electric and also has automatic switchover. When we take a step back, so this is where things start to change a little. That front half, you know, fairly common in a lot of the rear corner bunk models, but this is what I love. This is part of it. This is cool. Huge entertainment center right here, directly across from the couch. The reason I like that is, you know, when you're going camping, it's all about family. And on those rainy days, it's great to be able to sit on the couch or on the dinette and watch a movie together, especially with a big entertainment center like this. It also has a backlight right here, so when you do install a TV, kind of lights up behind it, gives it a pretty neat look there. These audio video cables are connected to this multimedia center. So if you want to watch a movie, maybe the kids are into Frozen or Trolls or whatever the hot movie is at the moment. You can put a DVD in right there, plug this in the back of the TV, and you're all set. This unit also is a radio. It controls the speakers both outside as well as the speakers inside, and it is Bluetooth capable. Then if you take a look, you have storage all around here. Look at this. This is cool too. It's strut assisted here. I like when manufacturers do that. When you have an overhead compartment like this, it sucks having to hold it up with one arm and then try to reach up there with another. I like we can just put it up and that way you have full access in there. That's deep storage there too for being an entertainment center. Right up top there is nice and deep. You have a cubby hole right here to the side. And then underneath that on both sides, you have additional deep storage area there. If we take a look underneath, you see all the way across here, more storage all the way through. So I know the storage here isn't too deep, but it is nice and tall. So again, it is fairly usable for some of the taller items. And then right over here, this is cool. You have a versatile storage area here. You can do a couple different things. You know, you'll see you have a hanging rod going across the top. You have removable shelves here you can take out if you want to hang clothes. If you want to use folded clothes and put them in there, you can do that too. If you need extra pantry space, which I don't think you do in this floor plan, there is a dedicated pantry I'll show you later, but if you had to, you could use it for that too, or linen closet, something like that. But again, myself, I'd probably use it for the kids' clothes. One of the favorite things about the Mallard line is pretty much every Mallard comes with this right here, and that is your central vac system. This is phenomenal, folks. You don't have to bring a vacuum with you. You just plug a hose in right here, and then you can go around, clean up your camper nice and easy. This is something you normally don't get unless you're in like a higher end fifth wheel. So I really like the fact that they put that in there. Right back here, again, take a look at the bathroom door. It's not just a plain door. They put the design in there. I know it's minor, but it helps with that eye appeal, helps with that pop. It just looks really nice. And then we come into the back. You see your foot flush lever toilet right there. Right across from that is your sink top and vanity. You do have some storage underneath. Mirrored medicine cabinet up above that. And there is, of course, storage in that medicine cabinet as well. Over to the side is your secondary door. I love when models have this, especially a bunk model. You know, I don't know about your kids, but mine constantly have to use the bathroom. This way they can run in, do their business, and head right back out. And then over next to that is your tub shower. Again, having a tub is pretty nice when you have young ones, especially if they're still taking baths. You see you have a hand wand there, big skylight up top, and then your vent fan there as well to quickly help moisture escape. As you take a step out, you'll also notice on the door right here, there's a robe hook, so that way you have a place to hang towels. And right in the other back corner are the two bunks. You have a curtain to close it off for privacy. You have one on each side here. They just kind of meet in the middle. In the industry, it's what we call a double over double bunk, meaning that they are both double wide. 300-pound weight capacity on here. And the cool thing about this, folks, is if you have older kids, you know, they're taller, they can still sleep here. It's a nice big bed. Or if they're smaller and they want to bring a friend, you can still sleep two kids to a bunk, too. Nice thick cushions. Take a look at that. A lot of times when you're looking at your bunk cushions, you know, they're like this thin. They're almost paper thin. The kids are basically sleeping on wood. Not the case in here. A built-in ladder as well. This is something that is often overlooked and honestly underrated. For me, I love having a ladder. And the main reason why, it's usually the younger kids that want to sleep up top. Your older kids, your teenagers that have the ability to easily get up here, they don't want the top bunk. They want to sleep on the bottom. But the little ones, you know, they're 4 or 5 years old, they love it up here. So the ladder lets them easily climb up and down without your assistance. And so I really value a ladder when I'm looking at bunks like this. You'll also notice you have a window in both the top and bottom, as well as a LED light in both the top and bottom. And then right out here is your electrical outlet. So if the kids are, you know, have cell phones or tablets they need to charge, they can do it there. And right next to that, you can take a look. You do have some extra storage there. Maybe if you want to throw like a duffel bag or something in there with extra clothes, dirty clothes, something like that, may not be a bad idea. So you move back up a little bit further, you see this super slide right here. This is what makes this so nice and open in here. Starting off, you'll see right here, you have your sofa. A couple things about the sofa. One, you can see how padded it is. It's nice and comfortable. You have armrests built in. That's a pretty big deal for me. I get super uncomfortable if I'm in a sofa that doesn't have armrests. And again, that is straight across from that TV. So you have a good viewing angle. You don't have to crane your neck. Another cool thing is the fact it's a tri-fold sofa. So if you're not familiar with a tri-fold, it uses the cushions like this one right back here. That's what your guests get to sleep on. So that way they have a nice, comfortable night's sleep. They don't have a bar in the back or an air mattress that will deflate on them. All the way across the top here, you'll see you have additional storage. Again, because it's a an overhead door like this, they put a strut in there so it's nice and easy. LED lights help brighten it up. You have the wall sconces there. Windows, you know, you have a couple big windows, especially this one right here, because they forewent the extra storage in place of the larger window, so letting a lot of natural light in there. Big U-dinette here too. I think that's cool when you have large family. You want to be able to sit a lot of people around here. You can see it's a nice long table, so that way you can sit several plates there. This also drops down into a bed. You simply remove the legs, table drops down, fill it in with the cushions, and that way you can comfortably sleep one adult, no problem. You can sleep two adults here if they snuggle up a little bit. It's not a super deep U-dinette, so again, they will have to snuggle a little, but it certainly is manageable. Another feature I like is this right here. Not just because it's a light, because yes, you're going to have a light above your table, but because of the fact it is LED. A lot of manufacturers are still using incandescent lights above the main dining area because it's generally a softer light. But I like the LED because it doesn't use near the power, about a tenth of the power of your standard bulbs. Then moving up, I had mentioned earlier, you have extra pantry space. Lo and behold, look at that. It tells us right there. So again, one thing, I love that they do this. It really adds a very residential, home-like feel. You know, I just think it's really cool. Open that up and take a look, folks. You have massive pantry space in there, especially for a travel trailer. I mean, that's awesome pantry space to have all that. You can put dishes in there. You can put crock pots in there, extra food, everything you need. huge pantry. So that's definitely a big feature. Another huge feature on my that I like about this floor plan is this right here. You have this built-in coat rack. This is great. You know, generally when I go camping, you never have a place to put your shoes or your jackets. You're always trying to find nooks and crannies to throw them all in. They give you everything right here. You have a mirror up top, electrical outlet right next to that with a shelf. The reason I like that, you come in, you need to charge your cell phone, plug it in right there. It can charge up here. It's not on the countertops, cluttering up everything else. Right underneath, you have coat hooks. Hang all your jackets up right there, your sweatshirts, your raincoats, whatever it may be. I don't know about you, but every time I go camping, it always rains. You have a little bench here, so you can sit down and put your shoes on nice and easy. And then when you come in, you need a place to put your shoes, perfect. Just kick them right underneath there. So again, I think this is an awesome setup, and I love that they put it in here. As we step up into the bedroom, another feature that I like is the fact you get a nice slider door on here. When you have a bunk model, it's nice to have that door. It just gives you that extra feeling of privacy. You'll also notice the queen bed right here. It is an RV queen, so it is 60 by 74 inches. And on both sides, you see you have a nice nightstand there, plenty of space. You have a cubby hole underneath and electrical outlets on both sides. So you're able to charge your cell phones or tablets or plug in a CPAP machine on either side of the bed. Right above that, you notice you have wardrobes there. They do have mirrors on the doors, hanging rods going across. You have a place to hang your clothes. And then additional storage right across the top here. Have the cool decorative glass on there as well. Take a look up at the ceiling, LED lights, ducted AC. This one does have ducted AC all the way throughout here. And then you also notice you have a spot to put a TV. They put a backer in the wall here so you know exactly where to install it. Then the appropriate connections are right up top. Now that we've seen the inside, let's take a quick look at some of the outside features on the Mallard M312. Starting right up front, you have two 20-pound propane tanks with a cover. Easy to get in there. Just undo these two thumb screws, lift the door, and you are down and in. Behind that, you see rails here for your battery box. And then coming up the front, you have black diamond plating on the lower part here to protect the front end from some of the rocks and debris that will get thrown up by your tow vehicle. And then up above that, you have the gorgeous Mallard front cap. Not only does this look great, but it's also nice and easy to clean. You know, you can clean the bugs off there easier, and it provides some extra insulation in the front part of the RV. You'll also notice it has some LED lights on the side. Just helps give it that, you know, little extra aesthetic there, and may help you find it in the campground as well. When you come around to this side here, a couple things about the pass-through. One, take a look at how nice and wide this door is. If you have some larger items like big chairs, grills, things like that, you're able to slide it in here. You have a covered hinge. That way your hinge isn't going to rust out. You won't have a bunch of rust coming down your door. It's magnetic. So you just put it up there, you forget about it. If the kids come by and, you know, they go to shut it, you're not going to have any kind of plastic clip or anything that breaks off. And as you saw, it is slam latch, so it just shuts right down nice and easy. Let's go ahead and take a look inside. Look how big and open that pass-through is, folks. Everything is super clean. You don't have plumbing running through here. You don't have cables. It's just a very clean pass-through, and again, quite big. You notice LED lights in here to brighten it up. And what you will also see is you have your controls for your power stabilizer jacks. One of the controls will control the front two. The bottom one will control the rear two. You can take a look right down here and see those. So again, power stabilizer jacks. You will still have to level the coach out, folks. You don't want to try to use power stabilizer jacks to level it, but these do make it a lot easier to stabilize when you're there rather than having to manually crank them up and down. While we're down here, another thing you may notice is that this one does have a fully enclosed and heated underbelly going all the way through there. It'll also help keep out road grime and hopefully help keep out some critters when you're storing it. Nice big awning on here. Take a look at that. Huge awning. Just touch a button to roll this out. Same thing to roll it right back up. It does have an adjustable pitch. It's really easy to use. You can pull it down just like so. You can do that on the other side as well. It lets you adjust the entire angle or one side or another for water runoff. And then if you look in the awning itself there, right in the barrel, you have an LED light strip. Neat thing about that, one, it's super easy. If you notice, that the awning is pretty high, so to hang up your own lights is pretty tough. So it's nice that this is up there for you, just a flip of a switch. Plus, because it's in the barrel, it shines down on your campsite rather than out at your neighbors, so it brightens up the area that you want. You have two entrances and exits into this RV. You have one right up here, the other one in the back. Both of them have three pull-out steps. One of the other features I really like, take a look at this right here. If you can see it, see how my hand's lit up? There are actually step lights on here. I don't know about you, but sometimes when I'm out camping, I may have a beer or two. Late at night, it makes it really nice to be able to see when you're entering or exiting the RV, having the stairs lit up. So I think that's a pretty nice feature there too. Right over here, you see there's an electrical outlet. Pretty self-explanatory. If you need to plug something in, you're outside, that's where you'll do it. Fresh tank fill, or fresh water fill rather, that will fill your tank. So if you're planning on doing some boondocking or you're going somewhere where it just has electric, you don't have city water, you can fill the tanks right there. That is gravity fill. Right up top there underneath the speaker, or underneath the awning, are your speakers. Those are controlled by your multimedia center. However, that unit is Bluetooth capable. So if you're sitting right out here and you want to be able to control some music, you can use your cell phone, if it's a smartphone or a tablet, and be able to connect to that via Bluetooth. Take a look right down at the wheels a second here. A couple things. One, notice how far apart the wheels are. That's what they call the wide track suspension, which is essentially a spread axle system. The advantage of that is having a wider wheelbase means you will have less sway when going down the road. You also have aluminum alloy wheels, that way they won't rust. Not only they look great today, but they will look great for years to come. And you have nitrogen-filled tires, which should, in theory, hold that tire pressure for a longer period of time. Outside kitchen on this model, it's one of my favorite parts about a bunkhouse. The way they set this one up is really cool because it's actually on the other side of the entertainment center, which is pretty neat. And you have your pull-out two-burner cooktop right here. Pretty simple and easy to use. You can just fold that up like so and it tucks right underneath. And then your propane quick connect is underneath the camper. Now, if you don't want to use a cooktop, you'd rather use a grill, folks, you can certainly set a grill up here and use that same quick connect. No harm, no foul. You have a refrigerator right up top here. This is perfect for any condiments or beverages you want to store outside. TV hookup right there if you want an outside TV. Sink over here in the corner, good extra prep space. And then you also have an LED light to help lighten it up. And take a look at that wallboard in there. You have a nice decorative wallboard. I think that's pretty cool. You know, if people are coming over to your campsite, and again, just helps give you that pop and appeal. And this door, just like the rest of the doors, is a magnetic door, and it is also a slam latch door. Right over here is your black tank flush. This makes it simple. Rather than dragging a hose inside the RV and sticking it down your toilet, just hook that hose up right here, folks. That black tank cast sprayer is built in, and it will wash it out for you. And then right back here again is that secondary entrance. On the back of the Mallard here, we have a couple nice features as well. One, you have your standard square tubular bumper on here. It has the end caps you can pop off, which gives you the nice place to put your sewer hose. Mounted onto that is the spare tire with a cover. Hopefully you never have to use this, but in the event that you do, it's probably in the best location as far as access, and it has a cover on here, so hopefully it will be in great condition when you go to use it. Your city water connection is right back here. Your cable inlet is right there. And next to that is your outside shower with both hot and cold water access. If you take a look right up top here, you will see this unit also has backup camera prep. This is great. If you know, this is a pretty big RV. If you want a backup camera, having the prep makes it a lot easier to have it installed, meaning it will save you a lot of money. And that could be great. It can help you avoid hitting anything behind you, or more importantly, anyone. When you come around to the side here, you'll see this one does have a 50 amp detachable power cord, 50 amp because it has that second AC prep. Water heater right over here to the side. And take a look at this, I love this. Not only do you have that big pass through up front, but look in there folks, you have this secondary storage area right over here. All right folks, that wraps it up. Again, this is the 2018 Mallard 312. If you're interested in this bunkhouse travel trailer and you'd like price and availability, simply click on the link in the description below. Thanks again for watching. I'm Ian Baker, and let's go camping.